fellowship. This word is something Christians often use to describe an intimate relationship with other Christians. It's something that we need in our lives, and it's something that God commands us to have. Many Christians believe they have a good fellowship with other Christians, but the truth of the matter is, a lot of them are actually missing good fellowship. Good fellowship is not just going out with your friends and enjoying time with each other, or going to church with each other and studying together. Good, pure fellowship is when Christians love each other to the point where they are willing to rebuke and be rebuked by each other. If you walk in sin, as any human being does, it is very hard for you to see it yourself. It takes someone on the outside of the struggling to witness the sin you're walking in. If you're digging a hole, it's hard for you to see how deep that hole is unless someone on the outside tells you how deep it is. And a lot of times, we will just dig that hole deeper and deeper, and someone comes along and tells us we're digging a deep hole. We may refute the depth of that hole, or the size, or even that there even is a hole. We need this person on the outside to throw us that ladder, to climb out of this hole that we have dug for ourselves. Hebrews 3:13 says, "Exhort one another every day, as long as it is called today, that none of you may be hardened by the deceitfulness of sin." The deceitfulness of sin. That is the main problem with sin. It's not just that it causes you to fall away from God, but it causes you to not believe you're falling away from God when you do it. When you commit sin, many times you do not know you are even sinning. And this is where the fellowship comes in. We need that fellowship for us to realize that sin is bigger than we are and we need help. We must accept the rebuke of another, and we must accept that they are doing it for our own good. Psalm 141:5 says, "Let a righteous man strike me, for it is kindness. Let him rebuke me, it is oil for my head, and let my head not refuse it." We must accept that rebuke that our fellow Christians give us. A lot of times the defenses go up, but we must destroy those walls. We must get rid of them, and we must accept it from others. As Christians in this fellowship, we must learn to rebuke our friends as well. We must learn that we cannot always be accepting. We cannot tolerate the sin of another fellow Christian. For me personally, I was in total isolation with my sin, and I had no one to talk to about it. When I met people, someone in particular, they told me that isolation was not good and that I needed the fellowship of other people to show me the sin and to share their experiences with me and how they've gotten through it. And that really helped me get through my sin and my issues. We must rebuke as a friend instead of punishing them or getting angry at them. We must show them loving rebuke. We mustn't ostracize or shun them because of their sin. We must tell them in a loving way. Proverbs 27:5-6 says, "Better is open rebuke than hidden love. Faithful are the wounds of a friend, profuse are the kisses of an enemy." Yes, rebuke might hurt, but if done in a loving way and in a way which clarifies the person's sin, it is far better than the acceptance of an enemy, someone who believes that your sin is fine and your sin is okay. We are never to do anything on our own. Fellowship is lack of isolation. Fellowship is lack of closing yourself off, bringing up your walls. We are all members of the same body. We are all members of God's church, but we are all different members of that body. Corinthians 12:12. "For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ." Others are there to help us. They have different experiences from us. We have different experiences from them. And we need to come together to learn about God through our fellowship with each other. And we are called to rebuke and accept that rebuke from one another. Only then can we truly walk with the Lord.